Hi and welcome on the Hands On Time. My name is Mal and I'm doing watch reviews for you. So the topic of today is about the state of my collection. Okay, I'm gonna do a quick video on what is still in my collection and what I did not kept in my collection. So let's dig in and let's start, you know, let's not wait. So the first watch that is still in my collection is the one that I have here on my wrist. And this is this beautiful little Pablo Raef. A watch that is a Cartier Tank homage that I paid at the time 11 euros, you know, only for this watch. Really nice watch. You can find the review on my channel if you want to know, and I still have it and I'm not gonna sell it. It's really nice watch that I wear like this casually, and yeah, it's still in my collection and I don't regret buying it. So that was the first watch. The second watch, when I, you know, really want to have this Cartier tank sort of style, you know, but with a suit, because I'm wearing this one casually, would be this beautiful Yema tank that I found on the vintage market. Beautiful watch, really nice. I'm so happy to have this watch, you know, it's beautiful, and that's the one I would wear, you know, with suits. Really nice. Won't quit my my collection, you know, anytime. It's a watch that that is definitely a keeper. That one was made for the 30th anniversary, I think, and it's beautiful. So that one is still in my collection. I'm not doing them, you know, in any particular order. I'm gonna show you a watch that is not working anymore, sadly, but I still have. So the time is working, as you can see the seconds here, they work, and the minutes and the hours works as well, but the chrono is dead, sadly. I have this watch since so many years, I don't even remember when I bought it. It's a Pulsar from Seiko. So like Loris, you know, Pulsar is owned by Seiko, and that one is beautiful. I'm gonna replace it with another watch. I'm not gonna tell you which one, okay? Just stay put and you'll see. I found, you know, a replacement for this watch, but still, you know, I can't trash this watch because I love it so much. We went into so many things together, I have to say, and it was made at the time that you know, Pulsar was actually, you know, doing wonders. I'm not saying that it's no longer the case, but their philosophy and what they are proposing today is no longer, you know, that interesting to me. That one was really. So yeah, I still have my Pulsar and I don't intend to trash it. So, like I said, there are no particular order in what I present to you. I still have this beautiful, wonderful Jacques du Manoir Rolex Datejust homage on a Jubilee. So, I love this watch, okay? Let's be honest, this watch is beautiful. I love to wear it. It's a wonder of versatility, you know. You can wear it with a suit, you can wear it casually. It's absolutely incredible and comfortable. So I really you know, advise you, if you are on the market for you know, a Datejust, and you don't have the money for a Datejust, the Jacques du Manoir is wonderful. So check my review on it if you don't know that watch. That watch is beautiful, really beautiful. I'm gonna present to you its 36 version soon, okay? So stay put for that one. There's a 36 version. This is a 40 or 41, I think it's a 40, yeah. And I'm gonna present to you the 36 millimeter version very soon, and we will be able to, you know, to talk about it. Beautiful watch from Jacques du Manoir, still in my collection, and I don't intend, you know, to trash it or to buy myself, you know, something to replace that beauty. So the next watch is, I'm sure you guessed it, the Seagull Skeleton. So Seagull is doing wonderful watches. I've done a beautiful video on that one. Go check it if you don't know this watch. Really nice. Really nice watch. Beautiful to look at. Amazingly reliable, you know, and accurate. The ST16 inside is wonderful. I love what Seagull does. For me, Seagull is the only Chinese, you know, brand that deserves really to be known. And any watch and 2DS, you know, need to take a look, you know, to explore that brand, because it's a wonderful brand. So the Seagull Skeleton, sorry for the coughing, is still in my collection. Then for the next one. That one everybody knows about, still in my collection, a made in Japan one, so I'm not gonna sell it. Beautiful, okay? It's not a Hong Kongese one, because most of them are assembled in Hong Kong. That one is made in Japan. Yes, Orient has, like Seiko, watches that are assembled in Malaysia for Seiko and in Hong Kong for Orient, and in Japan. So I always tend, you know, to buy myself some Japanese watches, and this one is no exception. Beautiful, the Orient Bambino second generation, wonderful watch, I love it. This is the tiniest of the bunch, because I think that there are five generation, if I'm correct. This one is the second one, the one with the hacking movement and the hand winding system was added to this one, and this is the best one. Okay, this is the most original one. It has its own identity, okay? The other ones look like, you know, cocktails from Seiko or Skagen watches, but that one does not. And it's a beautiful watch. It's really nice. The proportion are the tiniest one, so for my wrist, it's really nice, because the other ones were more on the bigger side. I'm not gonna sell this watch. I love it, and it's great. The Orient Bambino from Orient. So still in my collection, that's a watch that I can't sell. It's because my father offered it to me. Okay, this is a 1995 swatch that needs a replacement for the battery. 34 or 36 millimeter, I don't even know. It was made at a time, you know, when tiny watches were acceptable for men. Still are for me, by the way. And beautiful. So I'm not gonna sell it. I made a video on this watch with the swatch of my girlfriend. Go and check it if you are interested. The next watch, like I said, no particular order, okay, is this beautiful Casio. I've made also a video on these particular watches, you know, from Casio. And the affordable ones, and that one is no exception to my love, to the interest, you know, that I give to this watch. It's really nice. It's beautiful. When you buy a blue watch from Casio, it's actually blue. You know, it's not like a L'Oreal or a Pagani design, or you know, all the just Chinese watches. They are reliable. It's really, really a nice watch. And I have, believe it or not, a ton. Of compliments on that watch, when I wear it, you know, on this really nice mesh, beautiful mesh strap that goes so well with it, because let's be honest, you know, the strap that you get with the Casios in this prices are awful, but when you change it, well, that's what you have, a beautiful, beautiful blue sunburst Casio watch, and I really love it. So you see, you don't need to have a lot of money to buy yourself some beautiful watch, and when it comes to Casio, I think they are the king, you know, of affordable watches, and what they are proposing to you is just mind-boggling. Let's stay in the Casio world, and yeah, still have my G-Shock. So this is a G-Shock that I absolutely love. Was offered to me by my girlfriend, so I clearly can't sell it, otherwise she will kill me, but I don't want to sell it because I'm in love with it, so it's okay. So as you can see, really, really nice, still have it, beautiful watch, really beautiful watch. You have the accelerators, you know, if you push the button for I think it's 5 or 10 seconds, you know, you can see automatically. Let's try it. Like this, you see the accelerators, and it automatically opens the light on its own. Really, really nice, beautiful watch that I, you know, wear only casually, and I'm really taking care of this watch. I know it's a G-Shock. I must do the opposite, you know, but I'm not doing sport with it, for example, because I love it so much, and it was offered, you know, to me by my girlfriend. Wonderful watch, still in my collection, and will stay in my collection. Let's stay in the Casio world. When I do, you know, stupid things like going on roller skating on big descents, you know, that's the one I wear. When I swim, when I do crazy things, that is the Casio that I wear. I have it since, you know, years and years and years, and it's still here. I never changed the battery. I'm swimming with this watch because with digital Casios, even at 50 meters, you can swim, you know, with a 50 meter watch, you know, you cannot swim. You're not supposed to swim with it, but with that one you can, and it's a beautiful watch. I really love that watch, and it reminds me of my motorcycle, you know, the kilometers instrument of, you know, to know the speed on my motorcycle. And I love this watch, still have it, still doing, you know, crazy thing with it. Okay, the next one will be that one. A watch that I presented to you not so long ago, and it's the Briston Clubmaster. Wonderful watch. I've worn it a lot since then, and I really love it. It's really, really agreeable. It's really comfortable. Okay, it's really lightweight, and I still love this watch. It's beautiful. I'm gonna maybe replace the strap and put it on its original strap, you know, to have a taste of how it feels with the NATO. Okay, and yeah, it's really a beautiful watch. And go and check my review on the guy that is you know, actually creating these watches. He has a wonderful history. So yeah, I still have my Briston, and I'm not going to sell it. So that was the next one. So what do we have next? Next we have a watch. So that watch I really love, from a company that really needs to be, you know, more recognized, and that's the Zeppelin, the wonderful Zeppelin Moon Phase. So I did a video on this watch. Sorry, on the review I was sick, so bear with me if you want to check out you know, this video. I was sick on it, and I had trouble making it, but I did it for you, so go and check it. This watch is beautiful, you know. I mean, it's speaks on its own, you know. The quality of the strap that they are giving you, you know, it's not assemble, you know, a reconstitution of leather, you know, it's actual leather. Everything smells quality on this watch. It's a beautiful watch. Really, go and check my review on this one. I'm not gonna sell it. It's actually amazing that you can have, you know, you can buy yourself for less than 200 euros a watch like this that truly looks like a Patek. I mean, look at that sunburst, and look at all the complication and all the things that this watch is offering to you. It's crazy. So if you're interested, you know, go and check my review on it. Beautiful watch, still in my collection. The next one, offered by my girlfriend as well, so I'm not, you know, allowed to sell it, but I will never sell it, so it's okay. Like the G-Shock, the Orient Mako 2. Wonderful watch. Orient, crazy, crazy, crazy watch provider. It's wow. The Orient Mako 2, I really am enjoying this watch, you know. I even want now to have a Ray 2 and to have a Kamasu, and you know, I want all the line. Yeah, really nice. I mean, these divers from Orient are way better than you know, the entry level divers from Seiko, and there is no doubt in my mind that what I've just said is true. You know, they are offering you so much more. Beautiful with the in-house movement, you know, really, really nice. And this one is discontinued, so if you want one, you know, grab one and do it quickly. Really nice. I love this watch. Made in Japan, like the other one, you know, not a sample in Hong Kong. Really, really nice. The Orient Mako 2, and that's another watch that is going to stay in my collection. So all the watches that I presented to you, I don't have any second thoughts on them, okay? And I'm still, you know, advising you to buy them. One review I made, you know, in the past, and In that review, I was presenting to you that watch, which is the L'Oreal Day-Date. Okay, I still have it. Well, that watch, I said to you at the end, you know, what do you think? Do you think it's a good watch? Do you think, because I had some problems with this watch, I wanted to know what were your thoughts about it. Well, I do have second thoughts on this watch, and the second thoughts that I do have on this watch is that go buy it. I love it. I went to Romania with this watch. I swam with this watch. I've done everything I needed to do over there with this watch, and it was really good. It was a good experience. So, yeah, I had some problems. There were some problems on the date window. As you can see, the THU of Thursday is on the downside. I don't think you can see it on the downside of the window. And I had some trouble with the movement, but that was on my copy, okay? So I think that if you, you know, buy yourself a good copy of that watch, I think you would be just fine. And it's a beautiful watch, and I actually love it. I actually love this watch, okay? I learned to love it. I really like this watch, and I'm not gonna sell it because that watch has one or two problems. But I love it. I love this watch, and I'm advising you to buy it if you want one. And I just wish that your copy will be just fine, you know, because I think it's a problem just with my copy. So let's stay in the world of L'Oreal's. And let's talk about a watch that has zero problem, okay? No problems at all. And it's the Submariner, the L'Oreal Submariner Homage, the Rolex Submariner Homage. No, zero problem with that one. Beautiful watch. You don't need to buy yourself, you know, Pagani designs or San Martin and put, you know, 300 euros in a Chinese watch, you know. I think that this is too much for a Chinese watch, even the San Martin and the Chronos, and we don't need to have a 100,000 Rolex Homage. You know, you need one, and a good one, and that one I think is the good one because it's 57 euros, guys. Okay, and it checks Department Sapphire Crystal ST16 inside from Seagull, which is reliable, beautiful case. From an ancient, Rolex, and 40 millimeters, you know, not a big watch. So it goes on many different sizes of wrists. If you buy it from the L'Oreal official store, you will experience a wonderful watch with no back play, you know, on the on the bezel that aligns perfectly. I mean, why do you need to buy yourself a 400, you know, euros San Martin from China, for example, when you can buy this one, you know? I mean, it's the same thing, but maybe the San Martin has some stuff that are, you know, better, some better specs, but I don't think I'm ready, you know, right now to put 400 or 500 euros, you know, on a Chinese watch. If really I want to have, you know, quality, well, it's either you have the money to buy yourself a real Rolex Submariner, or you buy yourself, you know, something like a Steinhardt from Germany, or I don't know, a Ginot, you know, from the United States, but not a Chinese watch. Okay, Seagull is wonderful, but all the other, you know, other Chinese, you know, brands have something that are really, really nice, like for L'Oreal. Well, that one, you know, this is the old version. I bought myself too, but you always gamble, you know, on them. You know, you always gamble. You don't have any customer service and things like that. So, me, I'm good with these ones. Okay, I have two of them. They are beautiful. They work perfectly. I have no back play. They are reliable. Everything is fine about them, and I'm good with that. You know, I don't need to buy myself to have like 100, you know, other Rolex Submariner Homages. And if I buy myself a diver, you know, I would buy myself another one. You know, something that is not like the Rolex Submariner, or has its own identity. Okay, so yeah, still I'm advising you to buy these L'Oreal's. I think these are the best for the price. These are the best. Okay, better than the Paganis or the Alphas or the Parnis, or you know, all these brands that all of you knows, I'm sure. So the next one that I particularly love beautiful watch is that one, the Leap. Leap Marinier, French, okay, brand. Beautiful watch, 200 meters of water resistance. That's another diver, and it's real. And it's a GMT, you know. What on earth would you found? Would you find, you know, on the market for less than 200 euros that have the has the specs, you know, with the history behind, you know, the Leap company, which is a French company. Beautiful, really, really nice. I love everything about this watch. I wear it a lot, you know, and it's a GMT. I went to Romania with that watch as well, and it's wonderful. Wear super fine, 39 millimeters. The case is 39 millimeters, really nice. Sorry for the coughing, but like I said in the other videos, you know, I had the COVID, and sometimes you cough like even weeks after having that awful disease. So stay away, you know, from that disease if you can. Last but not least, yeah, this is the last one, is my wonderful Vostok that I truly love. I wear this watch a lot, mechanical, beautiful. Really, really nice. I forgot to tell you, you know, in, I'm sure you know, in the other video, this, if you see, you see the crown, it moves like this, it's normal, okay? It's a mechanism that allows the watch to fall, because that watch was made for the Russian army, and not and not to break, you know? So, no, it's not broken. Okay, this is just for it not to break, because if it's too stiff, you know, like the other watches, sometimes it breaks. So this is absolutely normal. The game here that you have here, it's normal. Okay, so Vostok, beautiful, really beautiful. I still love this watch, still have it, and it's a wonderful watch. I advise you to, you know, to jump on eBay, you know, and find yourself for less than 50 euros. I bought myself this one for 40 euros, I think, at the time, but the prices have gone up, I think, a little bit. But yeah, wonderful, and right now I want to buy myself an Amphibia, which is another Vostok, but that has 200 meters of water resistance, and you can actually dive with it. Okay, this one is only 30 meters, or even with the screwed crown, but this one was a field watch, and the Amphibia is the one that you can dive, you know, for the Russian army divers. So I want one right now. So which are the watches that I no longer have? Well, the $18 Guanqin watch that you see now on screen, I no longer have. The thing that I did not like in this watch was the sickness. Okay, it was too sick, so I had to sell it. The other ones are the Tevez T800 and 1A. I no longer have these watches. I sold them. I find them too cheap. Okay, I no longer want to see that on my wrist. What else? The Guanqin Speedmaster homage was a Speedmaster disaster. Okay, just go and watch my review on it. The date wasn't working well, so it's over. I've sold it as well. I put, you know, all these watches in a lot and sold it to a guy that was ready, you know, to service them, you know, for himself. What else? The Corgut Speedmaster homage, I trashed it. Okay, no longer have this watch. That watch was a nightmare as well. And yeah, and that's the one I really, really, really regret. Okay, I no longer have my Seiko 5 from Japan. Yeah, I sold it. So why? You will ask me. Well, it's because it was too big for me. Okay, I've lost you know, a lot of weight, and my wrists were no longer as big as they were before, and I had to sell this watch. So yeah, it was sold to a guy. He was in heaven when he saw the condition of the watch, because it was brand new. You know, I always keep my watches in a pristine state, and now I have to find myself another Seiko, because, you know, not having a Seiko in my collection is like, you know, not having a motorcycle. I feel naked. Okay, so can you advise me a Seiko, you know, in the comments? It needs to be affordable. Okay, an affordable Seiko. I don't have the money to buy myself an Alpinist. Okay, I'm not sponsored. I don't you know, earn anything from YouTube, and I'm not, and I'm like you, you know, I'm a watch enthusiast, and my collection is really my collection. I'm not doing this watch as sponsored, and after that, you know, reselling them to buy myself a Rolex, like all the big names on YouTube, you know, in the watch game are doing. They are telling you that they love the watches, and the truth is they don't care about them, okay, like we do. So, advise me, please, a Seiko, it needs to be affordable, it needs to be, let's say, up to 41 millimeter, okay, the case needs to be 41 millimeters, or, you know, yeah, between 37 and 41 millimeters, and it needs to be, you know, yeah, affordable. So yeah, I don't have, like I said, the money to buy myself an alpinist, for example. So if you can help me on that, you know, I would be really glad that you do, and that you do it in the comment section. So that's it for today. Like, subscribe, comment.